Hi, this is Cher from Cher's Crafting Boutique. In my last video, I showed you how to make some envelope pockets. And I have come up with an idea of something I would like to do with those. And I did start at first off camera, so I'm gonna move that out of the way and show you what I did. And all I done was get an A4 sheet of white card and then covered it in a pattern paper. That's all I've done so far. So, and then I've just folded it in half. And basically, what I have on my table right now is a few bits and pieces that I'm going to work with. I don't know exactly what I'm doing properly yet, but I have a couple of pieces here that were scraps, and I think they fit quite nicely on these pages, so I decided to get hold of them. I have the two pockets that I did, which is the one that I made the mistake on. If you watched my previous video, you'll know what I mean by that. And I also have the one that's on its side, and this was not my design. I did say the person's name in the last video, but I don't have it in front of me right now. But if you'd like to find out who that person was, if you just check out my previous video and it will tell you. So, I've got them. I've got my corner punch. That again is optional. I have some ink, some pearls, some little glass beads, and some bead caps. I have this reel of thread, which I got from my local charity shop, which was a bargain, 70 pence. I also got, I've got here some gathered thin lace. I have some ribbon that I got from the range. There's that. I have a couple of charms. I have some other ribbon here. This I got from Hobbycraft when they had them in like a bin in the sales section, which I got for £1. And I have the ribbon that I showed you in a previous video as well on how to do this, if you want to check that out. I have some double-sided sticky just in case, my hot glue. I also have some paper doilies. I have some tacky glue. And then I have these cameo pictures that I got off Etsy, and I would give you the name, but I bought them that long ago, I can't even remember. And then there's this little applique that you've seen me use a load of times, and I get them off of eBay in a chain of 10 for £1. Also my bone folder, and I think that covers everything, barring my 1-inch circle punch, which I don't know if I'm going to use, and a pencil. So, first of all, I'm going to move all this stuff out of the way. And I am just going to start by flipping this over so that I'm at the front. I'm going to take the corners off. This is just optional, as I said, because it's just something I prefer. You can have this any way you want. And then I'm just going to ink all the way around. Trying to stay in frame here. going to do the same for the inside part here. Side a second. So this is what I am thinking. First of all, I want to get something that's going to fasten. So I'm going to use this twine. Find roughly center there. Doesn't have to be completely spot on. And just run a little bit of hot glue along that edge. The one thing I forgot to pick up is oh, there we are, scissors. So that's the other thing I have here.
Mum's doing a video, come on.
I'm just going to cut that there, so I don't know how much I'm going to need. And I'm going to do the same with the other side. Just try and align them. The same place. And again, just hot glue that along there. Secure it down. And then just cut the excess. There we go. Now that I've done that, I am going to grab this here, I think. Get this up here. Cut that in slightly. Going to run a little bit of hot glue along there, a bit at a time. Just cut off that excess. Making sure you don't cut that twine. This will learn to stay flat eventually. There we are. Now, this is where I'm going to take trim here. Make sure it's on the right way. And I'm going to start here and go all the way around the outer edge. just going to hold it into the corner and then twist it round. Hey, honey.
Mom.
Yes, Salim.
Does my make a pop tool? I mean, Dad, can you say again?
Oh, you're gonna be more specific than that. I don't know what you're talking about, darling.
Scooby Doo box, like, has some things for YouTube.
Oh, right, you want to do that, do you?
Yeah, for YouTube.
For YouTube?
Yeah.
Oh, well, that was just down there. Is it not down there anymore?
No, it moved.
We'll have a look for it when I'm finished doing this video. Okay?
Okay.
Oh, don't do that.
Why?
It's very squeaky.
Like a squeaky noise. Like squeak. What? Who squeaks?
A mouse squeaks.
Yeah. And whose other mouse squeaks?
And then again, you just hold on to the corner piece once I just put that glue down. Hold it down.
Watch my...
and twist.
And you...
I'll find it when I finish this video, okay? She's just got a new Scooby Doo molding set and she wants to show you how she. She wants to put it on YouTube to show you. Where she puts it together. She's really excited about it. Continue to keep going around this outer edge. Hold on to the corner and twist it round. Hey, honey.
You have to do that YouTube. Then I come down, check.
Okay, well, I'll show you when I'm finished.
Okay. I'm not going to put my phone too loud, okay?
Okay.
Then I hear properly. No, look.
There you go.
It's my nose wet.
What you been doing?
Nothing.
Oh yeah.
I'm sweating.
And there's no way you're just sweating. You've been playing with the water.
No.
That bathroom's gonna be drenched now. Hold on to the corner again and then just twist. Okay, I'll cut off that excess. And my lighter is vanished. I've been doing videos on and off all day, and it's like when you get some to start something, you mislay everything. To make sure that that doesn't come undone. And there we are, that's the front so far. Just bend that a little to try and stop it from coming back up. Break that spine a bit, I think. No, it's not having it in a minute. Right, so now I am wanting to pop this onto here. I just think that is a beautiful picture. It's going to look beautiful on there. So I'm going to do that. But first of all, before I do that, you know me, I like to add my lace once I find the end to it. Okay, I got this free the other day and it came in this big ball and I've never found the end yet. Came to the end of my other one, so I needed to start using this one. Well, it will be here somewhere. Oh, there we are. I've got it. Panic over. Now, the one thing I do need is that pink finger protector, because I am terrible. So I have this. Thank you. Going to run this from this edge. You've seen me do this before, but I wanted to do this from start to finish with this project, so I'm going to do exactly that. Right, just a moment, because that's the door. Right, to this. Now, move that out of the way a second so you can see, just in case you haven't watched my other video. Now, just popping the lace around here. And you just pinch it together, just so then it lies flat as you go around. That out the way. I'll just cut off that excess there.
Got loads of glue strands there.
I know. It just brings the fabric back to you, doesn't it?
You must have spider webs on them to be.
Okay. So there's that. Now, I don't know whether I'm going to get my pearls out or not on this one, or whether I should pop this round here. You know what? I'm going to pop this on here instead. So run this from the bottom here, an amount of glue. I always put the finger, the pink finger on, and forget to use it. I'm terrible. I'm just sliding it into place, so then that way it sits properly. These glue strands are a nightmare. Right, then just pop that round there. Overlap it on the end here. I'm going to just cut the excess, and again I'll take a layer and I can get rid of the glue strands and just quickly over that slightly. There we are. Now I have this little applique here that I want to just pop on here. I'm just going to take a little bit of hot glue there and secure that on. Now that, I love the way that looks. It's come out really well. So then I'll bring the cover back over. I love that. But before I start putting that on there, there is something else I want to do. Take this off a moment. I have this, which I'm going to take a chunk of that ready, so I don't have to keep on winding it. And what I want to do, or what I'm thinking of doing, is popping this down the middle. So leaving that part there to hang down. I'm just going to keep on going around this. Ensure that I keep hold of the other piece so then it doesn't get raveled up and swallowed. I'm trying to stay in camera here, but all I'm doing is just constantly wrapping the middle a bit. I've done that about 4 times, and I'm going to come back up here and make sure that that's sitting right. And then just cut there. Make sure that's loosened a little bit because it seems a bit snug. It's pulling the pages together. Bending them through. Now, all I'm going to do here is bring one under here and the other one under the whole entire thing as well, and then just tie them. Just going to tie them off. Leave that dangling there for now. And all I'm going to do is put a tiny dab of hot glue in the middle there. Hold that down. Make sure that doesn't go anywhere. And I'm going to do the same on the inside. Roughly in the centre, a tiny amount. And then just push that down as well. So there we are. Then I am going to secure the cameo down. I'm going to bring that into the middle roughly. I'm just going to put some hot glue on there. You don't have to use hot glue if you want to do this. Use whatever glue you have. Now with this part on here, I want to take some beads, put some pearls here, move these over here. See if this actually works. This might be a bit thick, so I'm just gonna take that on an angle there.
Do you not burn it, so it makes it harder?
No, that won't work because it's more like a cotton. Yeah, I can try it, but it's got to go thin as well. It might do, we'll see. Yeah. Gonna need my needle. But I will burn the ends because it'll stop it from fraying. No, it's not going to go on there.
Put that one back in there, I'll get you.
So I'm just fiddling. I don't know if these are going to go on. They don't, then I'll have to think of another idea, but we're going to give it a try. And I do think I might add a bow to this. Let's have a look at them for a moment. Get these out.
Try that one. A massive hole in it.
Right, Thank you. I'll just pop these away because I've got out the colour I wanted. Browns in this. We'll see. I'll keep hold of both of them. Right, let's have a look. Beads, I doubt we'll go through that. No. So it's a non-win situation, I think. Hold on, it does with them ones. It does with the pearls. Now, does it do it with the glass ones? Yes, it does. Oh well. It's all good, it's all good. I'll use these ones real quick and then I'll take them off here. Well, it does with some of them, but it doesn't with them all. If you want to pop them down, pop them in the lid.
Want to open thing?
You mean you want to drop them for me?
Except that one.
More like about two or three.
No, just one.
Don't just feeding these onto here, the ones that fit in anyways. Nope, that one doesn't. Nope. There we are. I like that. Doesn't that look really pretty?
Mm-hmm.
I love the way it reflects the light as well. So I'm going to take that off there and leave that one on there. And then I am going to tie a knot on the end. And I got all of these from AliExpress, these little charms. I've had them ages though, so I really have no idea. They still sell the same specific ones. Charms for ages. That's why I'm getting them out and getting them used. I'm just tying this on this little loop here, making sure it's secured. And then cutting off the excess and then burning that end. Just to be safe, it don't come undone. There we are. And now on this one, which is a lot shorter, so it won't hold as much, I am going to do the same thing. If it lets me. It doesn't look like it's going to. It's just literally fraying. There we go. So this time we're going to start up a glass bead. Thinking, I don't know, maybe it's, yeah, I think I'll just leave that there because in consideration I have got to tie all this up, so tie a knot in that one. They just want to escape from me. Should have had my nail polish out, it would have been easier. Put a little bit of nail varnish on the end. I don't know if I'll be able to use this charm because it's got such a small hole. Let's see if I can try and poke it through with the needle. I don't think that one's going to work. See how tiny the little hole is? I think I'm gonna have to find a different charm.
What about the tree one you had before?
No, because it won't go. Well, I think I'll just hang it like that. I think it looks just as good like that. And then you've got the option later, ring on the bottom to add something else, which I think I will end up doing. Get a hold of it. Very fiddly. Yep, I like that. And what I'll do is just put a little ring on the bottom. I might do, but we'll see. There we go. And then out of the way before I lose them. So that is the front cover. And I like that. So now we're moving on inside. And I just move them to one side, back and forth, and it'll be fine. Right. Now, I have these pieces, as I was saying. And I'm just going to take the corners off. Just make them real quick. Now, it's precisely the size I want to pop them on at, so I am going to, I'm going to double side sticky tape these. So all I've done is take two sheets. I happen to have these as scraps and they fit perfectly, and I just made sure there's a gap all the way around, but that's the way I wanted it. If you wanted it to be exactly to the page, you could have easily just double-sided it, so one pattern on this side, different pattern on the other, because it's just literally an A4 sheet. Same with the other one. And then through the middle. There we are. That's that done. Now, I'm going to stick this roughly in the centre. And as you can see, I've left a border all the way around. But again, that's optional. being helpful. Oh, so you're leaving me without a job?
I'll take you for 2 minutes. Take you 2 minutes, take a break, boy.
Well, give me a chance to put this bow on and decide what colour to go with. I'm going to stick with the cream. I like it. Just secure that on there. Let's have a little look. What do I have in here? Yep, I like that. This little heart flat back pearls here. Put that there a second, thank you.
You're welcome.
And put that in the middle of the bow. Just a tiny dab of glue there. I think I've got these from eBay, but I can't be 100% because I've had this for ages because I used to like making jewellery. And now I don't do it as much anymore. Just using that I've got here. So pop this, see which way it goes round. Perfect. There we are. Put that down there. Like so.
I'm about sticky tape, please.
Yeah, there you go.
You need a little bit.
I think I will pop that across there once I finish getting that part in. Those ones in that needle, so I'll pop them out the way. Thank you. Yep, I'll pop them in that way. Find that ribbon out the way before I stick that down. Roughly centre it the best that I can. Should have left the front ready till after, but it's still working for me, so it's all good. Right, now I want this to be on this side. Yep, I want this on this side. So what I'm going to do is glue along here, and up the side, so leaving this gap here, because obviously I want to be able to use the pocket. I don't want to glue in what I popped in there, so I am just doing, like I said, along here, along the bottom, up the side to the space, and then up here. But that's if you have put this half circle shape in. If you haven't, then you don't need to worry about it. I'm just going to make sure it hits the bottom of the page. Only at the very bottom because I want to show off this pattern here. Don't want that covered up too much. You didn't really need to fill the full page in it, but I wanted that, so that's why I did it. so much papers that have to be used. I decided that I would do the full thing. Just secure that down. And then these will go in here like so. Make sure that doesn't come up for now. Just pop a little bit of hot glue in there. And do the same. I think you forgot yourself there. Sorry about that. The lights went out a second. So there we are. So there's that page. And moving on to this one. I would like this to be popped to the bottom as well. So that I can see as much as the back paper as I can. Again, I'm just doing the sides and the bottom. Roughly center it and then pop it down. Again, I'm just going to put a tiny amount of hot glue along that edge just to make sure that that sticks. Make that come back up just to help that secure itself. And then along here as well. Just pops into here when I can see what I'm doing. This is where I was thinking about putting this onto here. Like so. And therefore I'm going to run it underneath. So I'm going to grab, I'm going to do this with double-sided sticky because I don't want to see the glue for it. Take these out a moment.
I've nearly finished this third batch of tea dyeing.
Alright, thank you. Right, so I'm going to get the double sided sticky tape here and I am just going to run that across that top edge there. Yeah. access. Making sure I don't cut over the edge. I don't want to leave that sticky residue. But if you do, just use a little bit of talc and that will solve the problem. Kayla, messing around with that whoopee cushion again. Gone off hiding. You're giggling away. On the side first. And then put that down there. And now I'm going to take off the excess. Make sure I don't cut the end here. Run off giggling. She'll be back in a minute.
Yeah.
And do the same. Yeah. There we are. And that is that. Back in.
That's all the tea dye done what you want it done today.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So there we go. Well, this would be perfect as a gift for someone or even as a treat to yourself, really. And basically, it's just something you could pop in your bag, make some notes, and I just think it came out absolutely beautiful. I will be putting this on my Etsy store, as I've been making so much stuff, it's about time that I actually stopped hoarding it and start getting rid. I just have so much of it, that's why I decided to open a store. So only a couple of items on there at the minute, so I'm starting to build it up, and this is going to be one of them that goes on there, and I'll be putting that on at the end of this video, and the link to my Etsy store will be put on there too at the end of this video. If you go to the comments, you'll be able to click on the link there to have a little look. And this is what it looks like on the inside, and we have a fastener. And then here's the back. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel and leave a comment below. I have a Facebook page called Shares Crafting Boutique where you can post pictures of things that you have made to inspire others. If that's something you are interested in doing, please come along and join in. Thank you for watching. Bye.